Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Dr. Manu Sharma from University of Petroleum and Energy Studies, Dehradun. Today we are going to talk on the module Cross-Functional Management Information System, that is MIS, from paper Management Information System. The objectives are to identify the major components of management information system, to understand how a cross-functional decision-making model that can be used to measure the MIS performance using a conceptual framework, and to analyze the functional and operational efficiency in cross-functional MIS. Over the last couple of years, we have witnessed an explosive growth in the power and speed of computing, as well as rapid developments in the sphere of data communication methods and information systems, functionalities and capabilities. It can be claimed that information and communication technologies, that is ICT and information systems, have become a common, unavoidable or even vital part of business, political, cultural, social and also personal life almost in every part of the world. Besides, it's possible to argue that the above mentioned exponential developments, vast utilization of ICT and vision of the information age suggest that the trend of going digital will continue also in the near future and will have further mostly positive impact on business and society. At the same time, however, it is necessary to emphasize that in order to fully benefit from using information system, their acquisition and utilization must be understood and properly managed. Integrated Management Information System refer to a very highly organized combination of personnel, equipment and facilities performing data storage and retrieval, data processing, transmission and display, all in response to the needs of decision makers at all levels of the business, given by Hushner Cross 1978. The formal group of processes that operating on a collection of data structured according to the needs of company, compiles, elaborates and distributes part of the information necessary for the operation of the company and for the related management and control activities supporting. In part, the decision-making process is necessary to carry out the business functions of the company, given by Hudibus 1984.
Importance of information system. In order to have a viable information system that is responsive to a variety of information needs, all the measurable data pertaining to the organization must be organized in such a manner that it can readily be recorded, stored, processed, retrieved, and communicated as required by a variety of users. Conceptually, information system converts raw data into either a consumable report or input for a later phase of the processing cycle. Management science, management accounting, management, human behavior, data programming, computer science are all the interdisciplinary relevant functions of MIS.
The effect of information system on an organization. Every organization has one or more information system for its various management levels. These systems have always existed. Their goal consists of retrieving daily operational data, which can then be processed and used to prepare reports that respond to management needs. Managers of all levels must make frequent choices, selecting from a number of possibilities, not only to attain organizational objectives, but also to operate, control, plan, and supervise. A management information system, MIS, is an evolutionary design in which various organizational use one system. A system that exploits computer technology and makes full use of data information and human resources. In converting data into information and information into significant actions, the MIS provides tools for all levels of management so that subsystems may function adequately. Cross-functional MIS effectiveness may be used to determine information technology impacts on the overall business productivity. A number of effectiveness measures have been identified to evaluate the effectiveness of cross-functional MIS in the literature under various names. There are six major measures. First, cost and benefit analysis. Second, multi-attribute analysis. Third, simulation. Fourth, critical success factors. Fifth, utilization. And the last, information approaches.
Cross-functional systems. It is possible to categorize information systems into three main groups: functional systems, cross-functional systems, and integrated system solutions. The functional systems are information systems that focus on a particular business function. Thus, it's possible to divide these systems into following categories: accounting, finance, marketing, sales, and production and operations management, etc. In reality, however, these systems often do not support the information needs of just one particular department or a functional business area, but are integrated into combinations of several functional systems. To the category of the most popular information system, tools of business intelligence, that is BI, undoubtedly belong SFS, that is cross-functional systems. It may be defined as an organized combination of several functional systems. Eventually, their fundamental functionalities that are used to support information processing and decision-making needs of several departments. In other words, these systems cross not only the departmental boundaries and the boundaries of the distinct business functional areas, but may also cross the borders of the whole enterprise. In spite of the fact that these systems are more sophisticated and thus more costly to acquire and implement, they help companies to improve the vital business processes all across the enterprise, which again consequently leads to improved work effectiveness, time saving, greater efficiency of organization cost, and significant cost saving. Among the most popular and most commonly used cross-functional systems certainly belong enterprise resource planning systems, supply chain management systems, customer relationship management systems, and knowledge management systems. There is a constant requirement for a cross-functional enterprise-level information system. The main aspects of integration of cross-functional MIS are divided into integration aspect and the main characteristics of it. The first is strategy. The main characteristic of a strategy is establishing QMS first and then the EMS, EMS first and the QMS second, and the two systems simultaneously. The methodology includes the models or tools that are used in the process, and the characteristics are the national standards available to support integration and also the academic authors. The level for the integration aspect is the degree achieved by the IMS, and the characteristics will be no integration, partial integration, and full integration. That means all components of the MS are integrated into a single system. Audit systems, that is the integration level of the internal and external audits, and the characteristics of the system will be higher level of integration in internal audits than in external audits. The aspect of internal integration will be the global organization, and the characteristics of this will be increase of organizational efficiency, task simplification, optimized resources, management cost reduction, improved organization, time resources saved, departmental barriers, continuous work, greater ease of decision making, greater capacity to achieve objectives, organizational goal strategy, rule out conflicts of different company strategies, common management policy, objectives, targets, and key processes indicators related to the performance. Better and easier communication systems, and last, organizational cultural improvements. The another aspect of human resources and the characteristics will be improvements to risk management, competitive market advantage, increased employee training, optimization of training activities, better employee awareness of the importance of their work, and contributor to the whole organization and teamwork. The performance aspect will be understood by more competent workers, more motivated staff, increased performance, improved quality of products and services, increased productivity, increase in the reliability of products, improvement of collection and analysis of customer feedback, and also the reduction in duplication of policies, procedures, and records. More agile system, simplified MS, resulting in less confusion, redundancy, and conflicts in documentation, reduction of bureaucracy, elimination of conflicts, improvement of systems, understanding and use, easy to add a new standard, flexibility of the standards, better definition of management responsibilities and authority. Audit aspect will be characterized by unification of internal audits, reduction of cost of internal audits, simplification of audits, better use of audit results. And the market aspect in terms of external environment, it will be characterized by company image improvements, sustainability components in a global market. The stakeholders aspect will be understood by improvement of partnership and satisfaction with the main stakeholders. Benefits of using cross-functional management information system. It can be understood in interfunctional MIS as well as cross-functional MIS. The benefits will be efficiency, that means productivity, cost savings, reductions in mistakes and rework, shorter lead times, improved management control, improved customer satisfaction, improved in employee results, motivation, satisfaction, teams, communication, and knowledge. And the another benefit will be profitability. The benefits will be an improvement in systemization, in market share, sales growth, improved image, exports, improvement in competitive position, improved relationship with suppliers, improved quality in product and services, improved relationship with authorities and other stakeholders. And the environmental performance will also be improved. The framework for IT-enabled cross-functional integration. A framework that helps to understand the components of IT-enabled will be understood into three different components. It breaks down the overall infrastructure into three different, somewhat independent components. The first part is the enterprise architecture. This is a high-level conceptual representation of the organization. It identifies the organizational hierarchy and its components in the form of different functions and business processes in the organization. It also includes an identification of objects and events that occur in the business environment and understanding of cross-functional interactions and workflows. The second part of the framework is an information architecture at the logical level, which considers the objects and events of interest throughout the organization and develops an enterprise-wide data model depicting the relationships between such objects and events. The model also identifies business rules and constraints and data integrity requirements. Information architecture also includes a data dictionary or a metadata repository that helps to organize and enforce uniform data definitions across the organization. The model is then implemented on a set of interrelated relational databases that may be central resource or more typically a set of databases distributed over a number of nodes in the organization. The third part is the computing and networking architecture at the physical level. It defines the layout and specification of computing nodes and associated operating systems, storage devices, and physical database segments in the organization. This architecture also includes the specification of arrangements for providing telecommunication interconnections among different nodes, internally and with external entities. There are well-developed standards for accomplishing this task by using products from different competing vendors. IT-based cross-functional integration is a fundamental underlying requirement for the implementation of innovations to streamline, improve, and automate business processes. A recognition and understanding of this fundamental infrastructure requirement can contribute to its consideration and incorporation in the design and development of information system structures, right from the early stage of such efforts. Cross-functional information issues can be considered throughout the information system architectural design and development phases as a fundamental design requirement, independent of any current or future business process re-engineering or restructuring initiatives. Cross-functional integration is the establishment of mechanisms and links that facilitate the needed coordination of the activities of different functions to ensure that these functions work together effectively to achieve the overall objectives of the organization. Such integration is also needed across different organizations to create a well-managed, integrated supply chain of cooperative organizations with high responsiveness and low transaction cost. Therefore, CFI issues have been considered important at the intra-organizational as well as inter-organizational level. Effective utilization of information system brings many advantages to companies or organizations and consequently helps them to sustain in the market and bring profitability. According to Lauren and Lauren, information system may be viewed as so-called social technical systems. This means that in spite of the fact that they consist of the technology, they need extensive intellectual, organizational, and even social investment to function correctly and bring benefits. And that is why it is possible to state that the pure technical, technological aspect of design, implementation, and management of information system in business would not be satisfactory. Moreover, such approach that primarily focus on mathematical, conceptual, normative, and formal IT aspects of information systems might lead to ineffective usage of the system and consequently decrease its value. And that is why management information systems approach, which combines the behavioral approach, computer and management science and operation research with a practical orientation towards developing system solutions to real-world problems and managing IT resources, the best choice in the system selection, design, implementation, training, and also maintenance processes. Thus, it is possible to state that the corporate environment, politics and culture, as well as managerial decision-making, business processes, activities, and individual information processing needs of the specific departments, employees, groups, or even individuals should be reflected in the overall design and specific features and functions of information system. As Lauren and Lauren claim, technology must be changed and designed, sometimes even de-optimized, to fit organizational and individual needs. Organizations and individuals must also be changed through training, learning, and planned organizational change to allow technology to operate and prosper. Finally, an extremely important aspect that directly spells the difference between the success and failure of IT or information system utilization is the information system project management, including the benefits management, which may be considered as a key component of MIS. The computer technology and information systems have become a common and unavoidable or even vital part of the information age, as they have the power to bring enormous benefits to individuals, businesses, organizations, and the whole society. Cross-functional system solutions such as SCM, CRM, ERP, or integrated enterprise suites enable businesses to electronically exchange data and information anytime and anywhere in the world with other end users. Customers, suppliers, and business partners thus help businesses collaborate more creatively, manage their information processing tasks, business processes, and organizational resources and operations more effectively. And thus, consequently, it helps companies to build competitive advantages and successfully compete in today's fast-changing global economy. Besides enterprises, especially the small-sized one, in order to fully benefit from technology, should focus on the alignment of information system, IT acquisition with business processes and overall business strategy, and follow the principles of socio-technical approach to effectively and efficiently manage and use of information systems. Therefore, a key factor that might lead to the capability of a company to strategically implement and utilize information system is the effective deployment of the MIS. Organizations are on the lookout for ways to improve their productivity and competitive position through the use of suitable information system technology. Cross-functional integration within an organization and other business partners outside the organization is required by the organization for development. Organizations should pay attention to build such cross-functional integrated systems in their MIS plans and strategy, independent of any current organizational restructuring or re-engineering projects. Adoption and acquisition of new IS technology should be made keeping in view the overall IS structure that is designed for CFI, that is cross-functional integration. Cross-functional integration provides a backbone upon which organizations can build better organizational structures to improve productivity and cycle time. Such efforts can provide benefits such as elimination of redundant activities, facilitate coordination and control, merging of different function units, streamlining of processes, improvements in quality, and significant reductions in cycle times. It also permits streamlining and automation of workflows, implementation of group cooperation and collaboration systems, and inter-organizational systems that help streamline an entire supply chain. However, taking advantage of CFI structures may require explicit top management attention and initiative. CFI could provide the basis for undertaking process improvements through approaches such as BPR and TQM. In fact, well-developed CFI structures should facilitate innovation and experimentation on a wider scale than BPR efforts that are focused on few processes. The issue of CFI needs to be addressed at the MIS planning and strategy level. Management should pay attention to the need for CFI in developing its overall information system strategy. Design of IS structure at the information architecture level and network architecture level should include explicit consideration of CFI. Selection of information system hardware and software technologies should be made only after considering their suitability and compatibility with the overall plan for cross-functional integration. As there are a number of alternative standards and technologies available for IT-based cross-functional integration, organizations need to be very proactive in assessing these technologies and choosing the right way for their specific needs. This issue should be given appropriate strategic importance in view of risk involving in making a wrong decision.
So students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. Close cross-functional coordination is vital for the effective functioning of an organization much before the induction of IT to support the information and process flow. In manufacturing and service organizations, sales, production, and purchasing have to be closely coordinating their activities to develop and adjust production and procurement plans to optimize inventories at all stages of production in line with customer preferences and demands. Budgeting, recruitment, manpower levels, and production capabilities need to be tied to short-term and long-term production plans. Activities of warehouse, good movement, various production lines, maintenance, tools engineering, and shipping also needs to be coordinated. Similar coordination is also needed among various functional units in the non-manufacturing sector. For example, in microfinance companies, coordination is needed between different functions that perform credit checking, quoting, rating, underwriting, and other related processes. Thank you.